The sea was quiet, almost too quiet. Kevin looked at the horizon, amazed by the view. Beside him, Mina Star gazed, her eyes wide with curiosity. "Are we lost?" she whispered. Kevin said, "Not if we know where to look." He pointed to the sky, endless, deep, full of mystery. "We have to look for the stars. The one that brightest up, that's the North Star." His friend Rania smiled. "It never moves." "It's how sailors used to find their way home." Adia tilted her head. "So it's like a light in the sky that never goes out?" "Exactly," Kevin said proudly. "If we face it, that's north. Behind us is south, to the right, east and left, west. That's how explorers crossed oceans, by reading the stars." "So the stars are like...
helpers?"
"Yes," said Kevin. "They're old friends. Even when clouds hide them, they're still there, watching over the sea." The boat shined in moonlight as Kevin entered the house. A soft wind brushed Mom's hair as she whispered, "Do the stars ever get tired of shining?" Kevin shook his head. "Sometimes," and he grasped the light they burn for billions of years, tiny suns, far away. "Sometimes they fade, but now at night they guide birds, sailors, even travelers on land." Big Sis' eyes sparkled. "So the stars know every path in the world?" Kevin smiled. "Maybe even more than maps do." They sat close together, gazing at the maps and Theski that stretched forever. Each star seemed to whisper softly, "Find your way. Keep exploring."